Hello, I'm Avetis, or Avetis Fokiensa, because I'm from Alsace in France, or between France and Germany. I'm currently the director of the INRAE International Center for Molecular Gastronomy. I'm professor of physical chemistry at AgroParisTech. I'm also the director of the Institute for Advanced Studies in Gastronomy, which is a place delivering a master at the University of Reims in Champagne. And I have also many other duties which are very exciting, but I will skip that. The fact is that the 25th of March this year, I shall present molecular gastronomy and its applications at RCA. More precisely, I have to explain that Nicolas Curty from Oxford and myself, in 1988, we created molecular gastronomy as a science of nature, and more precisely, the science that looks for the mechanism of phenomena occurring during cooking. Okay. When you cook, there are certain transformations. For example, meat turns brown, or the cake expands, or and so on. And we use the scientific method, which are equations mostly, to guess what's going on. Okay. Many people confuse this with the modern way of cooking, but they are wrong. Molecular gastronomy is practiced by scientists, not by chefs. I shall show some example of our research after explaining what are really sciences of nature, why it is impossible to have applied sciences. But I will focus mostly very positively on the case of gels, because formally gels are very important for cooking. Indeed, meat, vegetable, and so on are gels because a gel is a liquid trapped into a solid. I will explain more during my lecture. But about gel, I will show that there are many different gels, kind of gels, and which is more important, many different flavor release categories. I will explain that. The second part of the talk will be devoted to applications. And the first one, the application for cooking, is molecular cooking, which is different from molecular gastronomy. You see, molecular gastronomy for scientists, molecular cooking for chefs. And molecular cooking, it's a name that I gave in 1999, but the story began in 1980, and the definition more or less is cooking with tools imported from laboratories of chemistry, of physics, and so on. Okay. Molecular cooking was very successful. It developed all over the world for years, and it created a new style, which was called molecular cuisine. So molecular cooking for the technique, molecular cuisine for the style. But all this is the past because in 1994, I made a new proposal, synthetic cooking, which means cooking with pure compounds, lipids, water, proteins, and so on. No meat, no vegetable, no fruit. You use the compounds. Just like in music, with a synthesizer, you use pure waves in order to create the sound and the music. And you know that today, synthetic music is everywhere, and the traditional music is very limited. Anyway, I will have to explain that I'm going all over the world traveling, explaining, but note by note cooking, synthetic cooking, or note by note cooking. This is the name I gave because I had the feeling that people were not ready to practice and to consume synthetic cooking, but it's the same, huh? And I will be able to show many pictures from all over the world, from chefs that practice already note by note cooking, and I can tell you that this is the future. Today, there is no other big trend in cooking. And for many, many reasons, note by note cooking is the future. By the way, if I have the time at the end, I will be able to explain the publication of the Handbook of Molecular Gastronomy that we are going to publish in April this year at CRC Press. It's a huge book on molecular gastronomy, 150 authors from all over the world, from all the labs that were created for molecular gastronomy, the science, remember, the science of nature. So these people made chapters in this book. There are 1,000 pages, more than 600 pictures. So it's an event. And well, let's meet at RCA 25th of March.